4 to 5 years of patiently waiting. And not only that, but also waiting for the full album to release before any of the tracks that came out beforehand. For this moment right here. This moment right here. Today is a very special day, my friends, because one of my favorite artists of all time since 2018, like a very, very long time, has released their first album. And that's no one other than More Kismet. What's going on, Andrew Promites here? Welcome back to another reaction video. Today, we are listening to the brand new More Kismet album, Universe. Very, very, very long-awaited album from 17-year-old non-binary EDM electronic singer, producer, songwriter, artist, graphic designer. They do it all. I first found them out when I was 13, really taking on a Ricky San inspiration. And I love Ricky San. So hearing their music as well was awesome. I absolutely loved it. I loved everything about it. And they've slowly evolved into a more colorful, melodic, while still being very unique in this trap inspiration. And now they have, instead of just Ricky San, it's a bunch of different inspirations all just blended in into this beautiful style known as, well, More Kismet. I just like to call it color trap. I don't call it that, but like if I had to name it something, I know people are like frick genres and I get it, but that's like the first thing that comes into my head, you know, is trap, and it's like, it's colorful, you know? I mean, look at the art. It's like, it's rainbows and stuff. So, you know, it's rainbow themed. So, this has 17 tracks. Now, like I said earlier, but I'm going to really let y'all know this. I'm gonna make sure this is stuck in y'all's brains. Most of these tracks have released before the album released today. We know this. But I haven't heard them. I didn't listen. I haven't heard them. All the Instagram stories, I would just skip through them. If I heard a little snippet, I'm skipping through it. Because I want the most raw and newest reaction as possible. Because I have heard, before I did reaction videos, I heard a bunch of these snippets. That's how old these songs are, but they aged pretty dang well, I would say. You know, they're still beautiful, unique, whatever. Call the Unicorn, I Miss You More Than You Think, Rumor, Vendetta for Cupid, Flourish, I Saw Laxity Making on a Live Stream in 2020, Autonomy, I remember like this much of it, Judgment, and that's all I remember from the names themselves. But I might remember some from just the actual song. So you'll probably hear a lot of, oh, I remember this one. So, you know, that'll probably happen. But ever since Rumor officially came out on all platforms, I've been like, okay, this is my drought. This is my drought period of More Kismet. I am not listening to any album releases of More Kismet. I've heard the remixes. The Illenium remix was amazing, and they did a couple other remixes too, and they also did, what's it called? It was a birthday release. A Wandering Chance, that. That was also amazing, so yeah. I've had a couple of More Kismet songs and remixes here and there, but that's it. Everyone's like, oh, album, and I'm just like, still waiting for the video day, just because, and that day has finally come, June 24th. And how perfect of a wonderful album release. I mean, I'm gonna say it. This is probably gonna be my favorite album of all time. I'm just gonna say it. The fact that I know what most of these tracks, like the little snippets of it are, I have really high hopes. But I'm also really excited to hear the tracks that I haven't heard at all yet, or I don't know anything about. So, or I hope that's some of them. The Celestial series showcases that were ages ago, I heard them, but like once. You know, I haven't gone back to them. I've made sure to be ID and snippet free as much as possible of the songs that are on this project. So, I did not take really any risks. So, let's hope this is all worth it. And let's just get started. I'm over here talking my ass off because I just have so much to say. And yes, I'm wearing the same shirt from the Revenge of the Unicorns EP. Yes, that was almost 2 years ago. That's how long it's freaking been. But may the drought exist no more. It's more Kismet album time. In my opinion, one of the most inspirational, unique, forward-thinking, out-of-the-box, creative, did I say creative already? I don't know. EDM artists in his time. Let's just go. The prologue. Another year of whatever. Is that young More Kismet? Is this like an actual beat? It's 3 minutes long. Turn this up, let's go. Gosh, the little down filters, they do that a lot. My favorite thing, ear candy thing about More Kismet music is their vocal work. I can't. We're getting a drop? That's hard. Are these all gonna transition? Because I know the next track, Calling the Unicorn. Alright, amazing start. Obviously. Call of the Unicorn featuring Tasha Baxter. Here we freaking go. So, I know the first drop has a sustain, but I'm gonna have to let it slide, bro. It's More Kismet. And the other sections are really sick too. Like for what, like the little, the not, I'll let y'all know. But I haven't heard any of these intros or anything. Y'all hear the vocals in the back? Like those little chops? Every time. Yeah, I remember this build. Alright, I've been told the second drop is like a way better, so. But that's all I've been told, so. Here we go. Come on. What? Yeah, that part right there is still my favorite. I wasn't expecting that really rapid switch, but yeah, I like it. I like it more than the sustain drop, obviously, because I really don't like those sounds, but I'ma let it slide. All right, See You Go featuring Courtney Page. I don't think I know this one. Courtney Page Nelson. I'm on Apple Music. Sold it to someone we both know. Slow. Would have held on. I hate to see you go, 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 go. Okay. Honestly, I like more melodic, more Kismet, more than like heavy. Go, go, if I had to prefer one. Yes. 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 amount I'm needing in my life.
God, that's so cool.
Painted chances. Oh, on a really good transition there. With the scene of me and you. All the fill. Ooh, garage? That was just a really relaxing song, but still really, really cool sound design. It's what I've been loving about some of this new More Kismet stuff. They've been able to evolve their style while doing like different kinds of stuff while it still sounds like More Kismet. Like this was a more relaxing beat, but while still being like dubstep. Ish, like glitchy. Love it, love it, love it. Is the next track what I think it is? I love this song. Oh my gosh, I'm gonna cry. I Miss You More Than You Think. Featuring Luna Matt. From what I've heard, this song is. It's finally here and I can listen to it. I think this is gonna be the album intro, but it's not anymore. The lead? It's the layering of just, it's like every time you hear it, you hear something new, and I love it. Here we go. Is the second track gonna be different? Let's find out. Yeah. What? Oh. What the heck is that? Stop. Stop. That was disgusting. Freaking kidding me? Freaking kidding me? I think so far this is my favorite, or one of my favorites. But I actually love the prologue. This is the prologue. Honestly, are my top two right now. Can't believe it's out. It's attached here. It's here. I didn't think we'd ever get it. All right, what's next? Rumor. Oh, rumor, rumor, rumor. Let's go! We're going in already. Oh yeah. Oh, I can play. So stupid. Here we go. That synth. It just speaks. And that bass is so crushing. I think it could have been a little less repetitive, but it's still fire. I still love it. I think I remember a little bit of what this next drop is like. This is such a clever vocal pre-drop. Yep. Ugh. Oh my god. We'll be right back. The triplet or quintuplet, and then right back into the quarter notes. Yes. Fire. What's next? What's the next track? Okay, Wasteland. I've been wanting to hear this one, because I don't know what the drop sounds like. That's like all I remember. Or that's all that I've heard. Here we go. It's more like a tribal pattern. All the vocals are so nice. Okay. Not expected. Oh. I think it's not better. Okay, yeah, that was a bit more enjoyable. Yeah. This is gonna grow on me, I think. Because I don't. It didn't like really hit me at first, but this will definitely grow on me. I still like it now. Really good song. I like that. All right, interlude. Progress, let's go. We're already on the interlude? Dang. Oh, look at all these freaking bangers coming out. Ah, what is this? What is this atmosphere right now? I don't know what tempo we're at right now. Okay, I hear it now. That vocal right there. Well, that was freaking fire. Track that makes you really think. I like the name too, Progress. All right, next track. Vendetta for Cupid, yeah!
I think what I'm saying is you're under arrest.
This one got the four on the floor energy. Oh, this intro's so epic! Y'all ready? Let's go!
I love that.
Oh, I forgot the track switch! Oh.
Woo! Woo!
Walls are closing and not supposed to be here, yeah, here we go. February seems so long. Everything on the floor, the wonder of everything, so it's never to come up, I barely made it out of.
Oh, okay, okay. I love when they do like a heavy section at the start of the song, and instead of like a heavy like switch or something, they just do like completely melodic. They did that with the Illenium remix, and it's just It's really taking this whole album in. What's next? Yeah! Chorus! Love Laxity also. Absolutely love him. So yeah, I saw Laxity making this on a live stream. I was like, oh my gosh, more Kismet Club? I gotta watch this. Fire. What's next? Okay, Parallel Heartbreak. I'm excited to hear this one. Lab's piano. Nice, 10 out of 10. Last night, by myself again. I don't think I know this one. Way too far ahead. Who's the vocalist? I don't understand why you still post up in my head. Pauline here, yeah. She's really good. This one's definitely gonna be chill, right? Oh. What? What? Oh. Oh my. Nope, I haven't heard this before. See, I love that point, isn't it, right there? There's another ID that's not out yet still that sounds kind of like this one, and I absolutely love it. Drop it on a little longer, but I'll take it. Bing, boom, 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 metronome. That was gorgeous. Freaking gorgeous. Gorgeous. What's next? Autonomy featuring Tor. Okay, this is the rap song, right? Are we nearing the end? Yeah, kind of are. We're on track 11 out of 17. You look at me like a bad guy. Pull me apart like a riptide. Leave me alone. There's that signature More Kismet little vocal in the back. Love that. There it is. I actually really like the distortion. Has a nice little dirty touch to it. Falling's happening. Or maybe it's just my speaker. Okay, I thought Morten was gonna rap more, but get it? Morten's gonna rap more. No, that. I'm sorry. Dead joke. That. But still, a really sick song. I love that. Okay, Ultraviolet. featuring Cookie. Oh, it's a collab with Chuck Sutton. Let's go.
Frequencies are meant to be you, be you, be. Until I try to see through me and through me.
Do I know this one? Sick ending. Freaking insane song. That was so fire. That was so fire. Judgment. Oh, Market. Okay, Aria Vale collab. Judgment. Okay, I remember this as a really early version, but I hope it still has what I remember. Oh, yes. Yes, 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 yes. This is 5 minutes too. Oh. 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 Yes.
Kill vibes more.
Off of this album so far. Shadow Soldier, okay. Featuring Lunamatic again. I don't think I know this one either. I might. Let's find out. Oh! I know this intro, yeah. Oh, this just the whole idea? Okay. This one will also definitely grow on me. When I first heard it, like in the little snippet, I wasn't a huge fan of like the drum pattern. But I kind of get it now. And the atmosphere I just is to die for, so. It's just so beautiful, but also like super complex. I love that. Oh. I don't remember this part. Yeah. This part's better. The little vocal on top. Okay. Yeah, that was gorgeous. That was just a little like breakbeat thing. That was beautiful. Yeah, that was really good. A lot better than I thought it would be. All right, Quest with Summit. We got this and two more tracks and we're done. I don't even know what I'm gonna say after I finish this. I don't even know if I'm gonna say anything. Wait, do not tell me this is what I think it is. Do not tell me this is what I think it is. No, it's too slow. Okay. I thought it was that one ID. Uh-huh. Where is this going? Where is this going? Oh my gosh! The bounce? Okay, I love this intro! That little vocal they always use, More Kismet always uses, that I talked about a bit earlier, it gives so much space. It fills up so much space in the song. And it's like a perfect amount. What the freak? That little vocal right there. Okay, this is like another little beat thing. Another little beat thing. I sound 50. Oh my gosh, just drop. Wait, this is freaking... What? Stop it. Okay. Threw me off a little bit with that key change, but it's all good. And that was a really nice way of coming back into the normal key that the song was in. That was dope. All right, Flight of the Superiority Complex, featuring, hold on, it didn't say, Liam Ello. Oh, this sounds. I can hear the vocal in the back. I didn't expect this one to be on the album. This is a beautiful way to end the album. I mean, we have an epilogue, but really good way to order, like, the track, like, a really good order. I'm so tired of this darkness. Maybe I just need some sleep. Liam Ello's voice is really freaking perfect for this song. So off, I'm sorry. I know this drop though too. Woo. I guess a lot of these tracks aren't really meant to like go so hard to, like, you know, moving around to. And that's why I haven't broken both of these chairs. I mean, there were some points, but I don't know. I guess I'm just like more focused on the actual song itself and like what the album is about. But we have one last track with all I have left. This is it. Comes in, it's over. Round of applause. So, that is Universe. I'm at a minute, I'm at an hour and 14 minutes. God, where do I even begin? I can't say every part of this album is perfect because it's not my album. Obviously, there's things that I would change about, like if I were to give feedback on, but they're very little things. Even more Kizma agrees. Naturally, there's a lot of things I change about it, but I'm glad I can't. This project is me, my stories, my experiences, my emotions. Universe holds a special place in my heart, and I hope it'll mean something to you too. Well, you sure damn did that one. Let's go through my highlights, because all these tracks are freaking fire. No discussion, right? Let's see. I loved the prologue, Another Year of Whatever. I really liked that one. See You Go, also amazing. I Miss You More Than You Think, Adore. Rumor, Vendetta for Cupid. Flourish, Parallel Heartbreak, Judgment, Ultraviolet, Flight of the Superiority Complex. Oh my gosh, I can't even remember what these last ones. What was Quest? Oh, it was The Beat. Yeah, I love Quest too. I guess my least favorites, I guess I should say, because there's so many favorites. Call the Unicorn, obviously. I know, that's gonna hurt. That's gonna hurt some of y'all, but Wasteland? I thought it was gonna be a lot more energetic for some reason, but like I said, it'll probably grow on me a little bit. Progress was, it was cool. It was cool. Shadow Soldier, I guess, but let's not be mistaken, it's still freaking fire. It's still freaking fire. I can't pick a favorite right now. I really can't, but yeah, apparently they're writing a second album. So can't wait for another 5 years for that. Yeah, I'm probably just gonna be listening to all of these. They left the dubstep scene or stopped making dubstep a couple years ago. I think like a little bit after Revenge of the Unicorns. And they started, now obviously there's still some dubstep inspiration here, but it's definitely not the stuff that they were making before. It's definitely a lot more, I don't want to say pop, but it's like, see, this is hard to explain. It's got a little more pop influence in it, like Parallel Heartbreak. You know, most of these intros do have a little bit more poppy influence to it. I get it, but it's still a wonderful blend. You know, it's not just pop. It's got a lot to unravel. And yeah, I can't wait to listen to this album 6 million more times. Most of these songs are pretty old, but they've aged really well. You know, and that's just how talented Mort Kizman is. You know, an incredible inspiration for many, including myself. And yeah, an absolutely beautiful album experience. And yeah, I'm definitely gonna be loving this album when I go to the beach next week. Let's freaking go! I mean, what a time to drop an album. I go to the beach in like 2 days. Like, let's freaking go. Let's go! Thank you all so much for watching. I hope you all enjoyed. If you did, please hit that like and subscribe button. And we will see you all later. Alright. Bye-bye now. Family rights.